As Hamas rockets rain down over Israel, a number of Australians are struggling to escape, unable to secure flights out of the country. Let's bring in Aussie, Ash Lilley, who's in Tel Aviv. Ash, good morning to you. Thank you for your time so much. You've been with your sister and parents. How have the past couple of days been for you all?
I guess one word is terrifying. So we were in Tel Aviv when it all started on Saturday, and we woke up to sirens and missiles being launched, having to hide underneath staircases. We then went north to be with our friends, but were then told we had to actually leave the north because Lebanon may be invading. And so now we're back in Tel Aviv, which, as one of the correspondents said today, we ended up having to hide again a few times under the staircase with one missile being really close. And it was, really distressing.
Asha, it's just awful. It's just honestly something we can't imagine. And we're kind of relying upon people like you, Australians who are there in the territory at the moment, to tell us the stories of how you feel and what you're seeing. What is it like day to day for you?
Every day is different, and every hour is different, to be honest. We thought maybe today would be quiet, and obviously it wasn't. I guess there's just, I can't even imagine what people on the front line are feeling, and we're lucky that, you know, we are hopefully going to be able to get out and go back to Australia. And my heart just breaks for everything that's happening here. But every day, every hour is just different. You just don't know what's going to happen.
Just to reassure you, I think all of our hearts are heavy with what's going on over there, what we're seeing, and just the vision and the stories coming out of Israel are just so awful. What are going to be the things that you do in the next couple of days in order to get out? Is it possible?
Yeah, so we're really lucky. We've actually at the end of our trip, so we already had a flight booked for Wednesday night, so which is your tomorrow morning. And we are just hoping that by tomorrow that it's all still going to be okay and that our flight is going to be able to get out. But every single day, more and more flights are getting cancelled, and all we can do is just hope that we're actually going to be able to get out. Otherwise, I'm actually not sure what we're going to do.
It's very difficult, I guess, for the Australian government to handle the sheer numbers. But do you feel like the communication has been adequate? Do you feel like you're being reassured enough and that you're safe enough as can be?
No, not at all. We have had exactly one email, and we had one phone call today, which just basically said the same as what the email said. When we first called the embassy, we actually were told by them, oh, we hope it works out, as if we'd just missed a flight, whereas we're stuck in a literal war zone. So I think the communication has been shocking, and it's just not good enough. We've heard other countries have had their people actually evacuated by their government, and I understand that there's a lot of Australians here and that may not be possible, but just the complete lack of communication, it's just not good enough. What's the point of having an embassy if they're not doing their job?
I understand the complexities here, but if there's a message and from your heart, what is your message to Australian authorities back home?
Just do better. Do better for Australians. It's not good enough. I think that's my biggest thing, is just it's not good enough. We need to do better. It's so scary being stuck in a war zone. And we just want to get out. We just want to get home.
All the very best. Thank you so much for talking with us. Let us know when you get home.
Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you. As war in Israel rages on, a number of Australians on the ground are facing a terrifying few weeks ahead, with Hamas warning it's ready to dig in for a long and brutal conflict.
Let's go straight to Australian mother Emily Gian, who is live in Yehud, Israel. Emily, really good to see you again. Thanks for joining us this morning. How are you and the kids doing today?
Look, today's been a real big bundle of emotions. I was prepared to come on here and say, look, you know, things were a little, seemed a little bit relaxed today. And then news came out that soldiers that had gone to check one of the kibbutzim down south, which is where the infiltrations took place, had discovered while they were doing a cleanup of the area over 40 bodies of babies and kids that had been unimaginably slaughtered, some beheaded. And I have no words. Like, that sort of just got to me. And we, I've said it, I think I said it even here, that I've been trying to sort of hide that part of the situation from the kids, like what had happened with the infiltrations, and focus on what was in front of us, which was the rockets in our area, and not to, you know, to shield them from everything else. And I started reading it and I just started bawling my eyes out. And they're, you know, they're sort of, mummy, why are you crying? Because every little thing that, you know, they're on such high alert for everything, that any conversation that we're having, what are you talking about? What's happening? Mummy, why are you crying? And I just looked at them and it just, it was overwhelming.
Yeah.
Emily.
And that was, you know, sort of the reality.
From afar, that kind of thing is difficult to digest. Yeah. And you being there, how old are your kids?
So 4.5, 8, and 10.
And you've got to be a mum, you've got to be strong, and now you find yourself in a war zone trying to compartmentalise something that can't be.
Yeah. So it's sort of this nightmare that you're just not waking up from. And interesting, I heard an interview with an Israeli woman that had sort of been caught up, but it escaped from down south. And she said, you know, we always knew that an attack was coming from Hamas. We knew that living on the border, there was always threats and there was always things happening. And we always knew that they were coming. And never in our wildest nightmares could we have imagined just how bad it was. And that's the nightmare that's just unfolding. And as more, you know, every single day they're announcing the names and the stories of the people that have been murdered. And it just feels like every person has a story, basically. And that's what's coming out now. And that's just an unfathomable nightmare.
You know, Emily, it's sort of that question, isn't it, about where is the humanity here? Those stories you were talking about before, I read the same reports. I mean, it is just unimaginable. Like, you don't even want to think about what people are seeing, what's been done to these babies, these children, these families. It is utterly horrific. And when you think about the fact these are just human lives, I mean, these are civilians who are caught in the middle of this disgraceful situation, and there you are just trying to survive.
Yeah. And then you hear like a Hamas commander going on Sky News and saying, we didn't kill any civilians on Saturday. And, I wonder what babies are then.
There's a wider, political ramification story going on, but at the end of the day, you've got to live day to day.
Yeah.
So how do you do that? How do you support your family? How do you be a mum and a woman inside this conflict zone right now?
I think, I started off, trying to not really say anything, and then I realised, you don't have to tell them the truth in a way that, because even us as adults, we're talking here now, we find it unfathomable, but we need to find a way to talk to them about it in a way that's age appropriate. So I have been trying to talk to them a little bit more about what's going on and, get them to, tell me how they're feeling and, that it's okay to also not know how you feel, and that if they ask me questions, it's okay that I don't know the answer to. And so in that, we're just trying to sort of live our daily life. But obviously, I went out today for the first time. I went to the supermarket on my own. But we've basically just been at home. So it's, a lot of playing games and iPad, more iPad and TV, and then iPad again, just to sort of pass the time and keep entertained.
We're looking at the shelves, they're bare. We're looking at a prolonged conflict here. How do you approach that finally?
Every day's a new day.
I don't know how Emily's so strong. It's just heartbreaking.
Hey, Emily, look.
So incredible.
Our viewers here in Australia have they're wearing it, and we're a long way away. You're right in the thick of it. And we really so much appreciate you being able to articulate what you're going through, and we'd love to talk to you again soon if it's not too much for you.
Anytime. Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it.